Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Brittany, and if this is your first time stumbling across one of my videos, I do focus on fashion, beauty, and lifestyle. So if that seems like something that you may be interested in, please think about clicking on that subscribe button if you enjoy the content, of course. Also, if you're already a subscriber, go ahead and click on that notification bell. I upload twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays, and sometimes I'll put out a bonus video on Sunday, so I don't want you to miss any of them. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a review on the Bdk Parfums. I have two of them, so if you are interested, then stick around. So like I mentioned, I am going to be doing a review on the Bdk Parfums. I do have two of them. I have Rouge Smoking, which was my first pickup, and I still have the packaging for that one. As you can see, I love the packaging on this. It opens up like a book, so you just kind of pull it out. So cute. And then I also have Gris Charnel from Bdk as well. And again, here's the bottles. They all look the same, but let's go ahead and get started with Rouge Smoking, since this is the one that I've had the longest. Okay guys, so like I mentioned, this is Rouge Smoking, and this is how the package looks. Like I mentioned, it does open up like a book, and so you just kind of pull it out here on the side, and the packaging is super nice. It's a really thick cardboard box, and here is the parfum. So it's so cute. I am obsessed with this packaging. It is so substantial, you guys. Let me get the bottle out so you can see it. So here is the bottle, and as you can see, it says Bdk Parfums, and this is a company based out of Paris. And on the side here, it just says Rouge Smoking. So I absolutely love this. It is just such a substantial bottle. I just like holding it. It feels so good. It's super heavy glass. And then the top is like a resin, or maybe it's a glass as well, but it is, you know, obviously black, and it has BDK on the top there. So the notes for Rouge Smoking are bergamot from Italy, cherry accord, pink berries, black vanilla, heliotrope, ambroxan, cashmerian, tonka bean, labdanum, and white musk. So the notes that stood out to me that made me want to pick this one up were tonka bean, the cherry accord, because you guys know I love Lost Cherry by Tom Ford, and also the vanilla, of course, but this one has black vanilla. And again, I just wanted to try something from this brand because I've kind of heard a little bit about it. I think it is becoming popular, but it wasn't just like everybody and their mom had it. So I really wanted to try it, but this one was the most popular one that I heard about at the time. So I went ahead and just did a blind buy on this. And I was hearing that people felt like it smelled like cherry cola or like a Dr. Pepper or something like that. So I have been wearing this for about a month. And at first sniff, I can see what they mean when they talk about a cherry cola vibe. You definitely get cherry, but it's not like a juicy cherry. It's more of a, it's a deeper cherry. And the way that it mixes with that tonka bean and that cashmerian in there, I can definitely, it's not an edible cherry at all. You know, this is not something that I would eat. Definitely, it does have that like Dr. Pepper kind of scent to it. But something about this I really love. So my Tom Ford Lost Cherry, I find that to be a very sexy scent. I wear that for date night. I mix it with so many of my other fragrances as well. And like I said, it's like a juicy, tart cherry. Very edible, very gourmand. This is definitely not so much edible, but you still get that cherry scent. But I like this a lot. Now, what I will say is the longevity on this is not the best. This is a gorgeous scent. I feel like it's beautiful for fall, and you can wear this every single day. I'm gonna put a little bit on right now just because it does not, yeah, it's so good though. I love this. So I do feel like this is a unisex sex fragrance. Let me backtrack. This is a unisex fragrance in my opinion. I do not feel that Lost Cherry is a unisex fragrance. That's just how I feel. But this one is very unisex. It is heavier. Again, it's not like an edible cherry. It's just like it has a lot of depth in there. You can definitely smell that heliotrope. You can smell the tonka bean. I mean, the tonka bean is really performing in this one. But it's not like a super loud fragrance. It is a subtle fragrance, but it lasts. Okay, so and I don't even want to say it's a skin scent, but it's just not one of those fragrances that you walk into the room and it just smells up the whole room. It's just one of those, I guess it is like a close encounter type of scent. But for me, I would love to wear this every day. This is just, it's so unique. I don't think I've smelled anything like this, and I don't mind smelling like cherry cola if that's what I smell like. I have gotten compliments on this, and no one has mentioned that it smelled like cherry cola, but they just asked me what I'm wearing. And I won't say that people are like stopping me every 2 seconds, but they are asking me like, what are you wearing? That's an interesting scent. And that's the kind of compliment I go for. You know, I like that. I don't like something that's just like super mainstream all the time. And yeah, this one is something that I do not have at all in my collection. So I'm so happy that I added this. I would say that you would get about 5 hours on this one. But again, it is pretty close to the body and it's not going to be something that projects at all. So people can smell you, but like I said, you're not funking up the room when you walk in. And I honestly don't feel like every fragrance that we have has to do that. There's a time and a place for everything. And this one is just something unique that I was super happy to add to my collection. One interesting thing about Rouge Smoking is that people were saying that they smell like a smoky note or something like, you know, like a smoky scent. And it's not that. It does not have any type of smoky scent or notes in this whatsoever. It's more so speaking to the way that you would wear the fragrance, more of like a smoking jacket, not the notes themselves. So that's just so interesting how when you read something, it can kind of play tricks on your mind and you think you're smelling something that you're not. That's why fragrance is so like subjective, because people create scenarios in their head, you know, and we love a good scenario. So let me give you the scoop on this one. It says, at nightfall, the sky becomes misty, letting the red light of the mill glimpse through the window. The horn sound and the spirit of celebration comes to the city. In front of her mirror, she's getting ready and doing her makeup. It's time for beauty to go on stage. She goes toward her wardrobe, inspired by that tuxedo that would enhance her body lines. It is the Parisian glam, she knows it well. Her bohemian style and erotic energy leaves inedible footprints on the streets. She is Pagal, beautiful and mysterious. So one thing that I absolutely love about this is like that type of scenario. I don't even have to come up with my own scenario, because this fragrance to me is that sexy kind of like, when they say erotic, I feel like that's what brings in that unisex part of it, because it's given like an androgynous feel. Definitely a woman, like they mentioned, that is wearing a tuxedo with a bold, shiny red lip, hair probably part on the side with some finger waves, or just giving like a blonde finger wave if you must. Okay, with a bow tie, I mean, suit fitting to perfection, and a Pagal pump. And if you know anything about a Louboutin Pagal pump, you know that he created that pump to be super erotic and sexy. And this fragrance to me goes right along with that. With that scenario, it could kind of be a little bit vulgar. And this scent definitely gives off that androgynous, sexy, close to the body vibe. Now, you would think that when you walk into a room, she's gonna shut it down, and she will shut it down with her look. And the fragrance would match that, but it's not gonna shut it down to where it's funking up the entire room. But when she walks past you and she kind of gets her shoulder right up on you and lets you know what's up, like meet her right on over there to that stage, you're gonna smell this scent and you're gonna come crawling right behind sis right on up to that stage. So that's that like erotic, sexy vibe that I get from this fragrance. I absolutely love the way that they created that scenario. It is that. Now, if they did not say that and you didn't know that, I think that the scent is still safe enough to wear every day, because it's not overpowering, but it is very unique and it can be very sexy depending on, you know, where you are, where you're going, who you're with. So I absolutely love this one. So happy that this was my first one. But there are some other ones in the BDK line that are amazing as well. And let's go ahead and get right into those. When I received the Rouge Smoking, I did receive a couple of samples, and Gris Charnel was one of them. And when I smelled it, I immediately bought it that night. So it wasn't really a blind buy, but I didn't really give it time to like test it out on my skin, but smelling it in that sample, I was like, I need this. And that one has a lot more punch. And this is the bottle for Gris Charnel. So as you can see here, it just says Gris Charnel. And I love the color of the juice. It's like a purplish gray color. So cool. And I did not mention, but you do get 100 ml, which is 3.4 fluid ounces. So that is a lot of juice, and it will last you for a very, very long time, especially for the price. These retail for $180, FYI. So the notes in Gris Charnel are fig, black tea, cardamom essence, absolute of iris, bourbon, vetiver, sandalwood from India, absolute of tonka bean. Again, that tonka bean is here again, and I have been obsessed with tonka bean lately. So that's probably why I love this one, just at first sniff. But this one is so much more stronger. It's so interesting to me. It's a feminine fragrance. I mean, it's unisex in my opinion, but it has like a femininity about it, but it's almost like a super sweet masculine scent, which is so like, it's confusing, right? It is a super sweet masculine scent. So think of like a masculine scent, but they have like sweetened it up so much with the fig and all of that, and it made it into more of a unisex feminine scent. That's what I get from this. This one is one that everyone's gonna smell on you, and you will get compliments on this one, but it is strong. I feel like it's kind of polarizing in a way, but when I think of this scent, I think of cozying up like with your man, or just, it's just by the fireplace type of vibes. It's beautiful. Let's go ahead and read the scoop on this one. Okay, so this one says, as the night falls, the number of dancers increases and the bleachers fill up. Under the silver moon and the lights of the tourist barges that crisscross the quay a few meters away, the bodies mingle to the rhythm of the music. It is then that two glances cross paths. A discreet invitation brings them to the center of the track. As if they were carried away, they dance in the heat of the night. From this hand-to-hand seduction punctuated by knowing smiles, they end up slipping away to give free flow to more carnal desires. You guys, this, okay, listen. BDK is quite vulgar, okay? But I love the way that they put it in like this Parisian vibe, so you don't quite catch it if you don't know, you know, what the meanings are of these words. In the early morning, the sheets give off a scent of sleepless nights, mischievous and lascivious embraces. Girl, if you don't know what that means, the sheets give off the scent of sleepless nights. Literally that's what this smells like. And like I just said, what did I say, you guys? This smells like a masculine cologne that has been sweetened up to make it feminine. What that is the man and the woman colliding together and creating this scent. Like, okay, listen. This ain't for kids. This is not for kids. This is not for children, okay? This is not for children. This one, like I said, is a very strong, in my opinion. It lasts for ages and it projects, okay? This projects, but it's very cozy. It's very, like I said, by the fireplace of its sweaters and, you know, honey, all of just that, okay? It is just, look at my hand. It is doing all of that, okay? So I am absolutely into this fragrance, okay? This is one that when you put it on, just know that you're gonna smell it. You're gonna smell this on yourself. And if you're not really a fan of sweet scents, I'm not saying sweet like candy, but sweet as in super strong, like this could be a little bit nauseating. It can be a little bit nauseating. So keep that in mind. But this is a unique scent. I've not smelled anything like this. And that is one thing that, like I said before, I love about the BDK line. It is just something that I have not smelled before. And when you start adding over 50 fragrances to your collection, you start to look for something just a little bit different because it's almost like you have everything. And I was pleasantly surprised when I picked these up. So my next one on my list, you guys, is so good. I have a sample of it. Let me get the actual name for you guys. I think it is called Passoir. So that is another one on my list. I think it is beautiful. So had I known about Passoir first, I probably would have gotten that one second instead of this Gris Charnel, even though I love the Gris Charnel so much, but the Passoir is just a little bit more toned down. And again, another everyday scent that I feel like is super unique. And that's kind of like what I was on the hunt for, because a lot of my fragrances for the fall and winter is like for me to go out, even though I wear them during the day as well, they are like gut punching scents. And I feel like the Rouge Smoking and the Passoir is just something that you can wear every day. It's not too much. But you still smell good and unique. And then you have your Gris Charnel from BDK, honey, from those for those cozy, sexy, steamy nights, okay? And you and your man can wear this, but again, don't overdo it, because to me, this can get a bit nauseating. It's super sweet in a masculine way. It's so different, but you'll know what I mean if you have this or if you ever get your nose on this one, okay? Yep. All right, guys, so that is pretty much the end of this video. I don't know if I mentioned, but these do retail for about $180. I will link them down below for you guys so that you can pick them up. I am really impressed with BDK, and I love the way he sets the scene for these fragrances. You guys know we love a good scenario, and he did not disappoint. A Parisian kind of like urban fragrance brand. Love that. I just love that. Okay. So these are my two. And like I said, I definitely want to add another one from this collection to mine. And I'm super happy with these. So definitely check these out. If you're a little bit on the milder side, go with the Rouge Smoking. If you are a little bit on the bolder side, go for Gris Charnel. And here they are, you guys. These will last you forever at 3.4 fluid ounces. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this review was helpful, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.